Welcome back on Dynamo. Today I want to propose you the unboxing and review about the White Dwarf of February 2020 released by the Game Workshop. And we can find that this is one of the biggest White Dwarf released with 160 pages inside that you can read. So quite a lot of pages, and we'll go to see if they are worth pages. Anyway, this is a White Dwarf with a really nice cover, even if I like also the alternative cover, but I'll make you see them later. And now we can start to open this White Dwarf and see the contents inside. Here we can find the alternative image that we see later better in detail. Here we can find the theme of the White Dwarf, here the introduction of this big White Dwarf, and here the contents that are inside this White Dwarf. And we can see a better detail about the cover that we have here without any writing on, and I think that it's really quite amazing one, so really beautiful. So we can flip, and here we can find the part about the models of the readers and the mailing of the readers to the White Dwarf itself. So it's really quite interesting, and I suggest you to see these images also to have some ideas about. For example, there are scheme of colors that you can gain ideas, but for example also this image can be quite interesting to have some interesting scheme of colors for your Stormcast Eternals, for example. Or for example, if you want to see these ones, you can find a way to paint the Blood Angels ones, for the Air Blaster ones. For example, I have here my one, so you can find that you have quite a lot of different ways to paint the same model. So I think that it's quite interesting in such a way. If you want, I'll create also a video about how I painted and I monetized my Air Blaster, because they are monetized ones. Here we can find also this model that is quite nice. Here we can find other models, for example this one has the nice effect on the base that can be interesting to represent. For example, this is a model that it's a combination of the Terminators, for example this shield, the wings that comes from the set of the Sanguinor, here other options. So we have a lot of different ways that we can paint and realize things. For example, also this, it's a model that I realized. If you want, you can find in the description my playlist about how to monetize these models, that it's really quite interesting. And you can find here instead the base, so we can find that has been modified totally. And there are a lot of options that you can, for example, this about the Taos. If you go to see, there are a lot of options to see. And here we can find instead the part about how to collect your army. So this is an article by Phil Kelly to realize different ways to collect your army. So the architect way, so you plan everything, or the gardening way, so that you modify and you develop also the background of your army way that you go to collect it. So it can be really quite interesting one. Or for example also the way that you collect the alliances, because you are interested in something and you add every time some things. A lot of times I think that I'm in this part, because for example for my death I collect almost all the different factions of death, and I'm really quite in about death armies. So it can be an example, but all these ones are for example for me a way to collect them, because I do. So there are armies that I collect because I'm interested in developing them, but not because I want that army, but because I want to collect the different models, and step by step I develop it. Others that I collect thinking about a theme, and I really like it. So there are a lot of things that you can have. This we can see imagine about the Orcs and in Age of Sigmar 1, so they are really quite nice. I like these images that are referring with having the models in a nice scenery, so I think that are really quite good. Here we have about the Iron Sons, an article that it's the Tom Celeste, that it's the like of the Adeptus Astartes, but for the one of Age of Sigmar, but of different armies. So it can be really quite interesting, because there is a lot of background about, so really quite a lot, and it's something that I suggest you, because it's a background that if you play this, it develops the background that you know, so you can find a lot of referring. If you don't play this, you can know better these ones. So I think that it's really quite interesting. Here, the developing of the background of the Orcs during the Age of Sigmar time. And here, new rules to play them. So we have, for example, this that it's the Skull Battalion, and here ones that are new ones that you can use for your armies with the points. So they are official ones, and you have the points to play them. So it's really quite interesting in such a way. And then we can go to paint these ones. Moreover, this type of color that is the orange, that it's quite difficult usually to paint. So now we have, so it can be really quite interesting and useful. And we can find a lot of different ways to paint and develop it. So if you're interested in realizing such type of colors, not being pin only to the models, but see if you're interested, for example, the type of green, the type of yellow, this type of gray, that can be really quite interesting. And here we have instead a fiction about the Orcs, so we can have a lot of interesting information about with this fiction. Then we have the rules of engagement, that in this way it's about Louis Aguilar, that talks about how to create your own list, your own rooster. And even if I think that it's quite simple, this one, it's quite essential. So I suggest you to read and think about this, read about this, to have a thought when you create your rooster, to be able to have the different ways that it explains. Because I think that they are really quite interesting ones for the ones that want to develop a rooster. Then we have this about Warcry with new rules, and this that you can scan, because you have the option to scan and make for your army of Warcry. So new rules about the five layers, and there are a lot of different options that you can gain from this. All you can scan them, so there is not a worry about this. And so about Warcry there is quite a lot. Then we have a army showcase about Sam Wilson that show its army about the Sylvaneth. And I think that it can be quite interesting about painting and about, for example, the bases, how to personalize the models. So I think that they are really quite interesting in such a way to have a site about how different people can create, and you can have inspiration about it with different scheme of colors that you can use. So there are a lot of options. And here instead we can go to start with the Warhammer 40k. And I think that this WEDAF could have been the plug Nargol one, because there are a lot of things related about Nargol. So it's really quite interesting in such a way. Here we have a fiction about the Salamanders, that can be quite interesting. And here about the Domitus Crusade, and we can find how it proceeds. So in the Red Dwarf you can find step by step how this crusade develop, and I think that it can be really quite interesting to know better and understand how it develops during the time. Here we have about the Tale of War Warlord, and here it's the final showdown. So we have the final adding and the preparation to the battle report about these armies battle against each other. So it's really quite interesting. We have the Genstealer Kurz with the Generaptor. Here we have about the Space Marines, so a lot of interesting parts. Here we can find about the Nargol army, so we can find the demonic part and the marine part. Here we can find the part about the Black Legion army of the Chaos. So also this has a lot of things with the part about here the Imperial Knights, the corrupt ones. Here we can find about the battle report, so all the armies that we have seen then play together, so a specific battle plan with all the options that you can play. I think that it's really quite interesting. We have also the secret schemes that you can use, so it's quite interesting to play in a different way. What I don't like is the PowerPoint use for these armies, but you know that I don't like such way to play for Warhammer 40k, because I think that it's not good, in my opinion, as the details and so on. But in a way, it's a way that can be nice to compose your army, so it can be quite interesting. And then we can see the battle report itself that start, and goes on. So if you are interested, you can see a really nice battle report, because you can use these type of battle reports to understand the game. So if you don't know, for example, the Warhammer 40k, you can use these to understand how it works, how it can be represented in the different matches and so on. So I think that could be quite interesting in that way. And then we can find here an article that it's related about how it has been developed, the Space Marine Codex and the different supplements that has been released. Sincerely, I find it quite liking, because the different supplements, I think that they are not so equal as they are supposed to be if you read these. But the different rules that are inside, that are specified about the Space Marine, I think that they are really quite interesting to read, at least the base, because they have been decided to be put on. So quite interesting that way. Then we have about Nargul, so the theme always about Warhammer 40k, as you can see, that it's really quite interesting. I am developing in some way an army about the Death Guard, but because I like the models and I'm collecting, so the Warhammer Conquest part about the Death Guard, and you can find in the description my playlist about the Warhammer Conquest issues that I bought, and you can find a lot of different years. For example, think about this. It's a model that doesn't exist, so it has been modified and it has been recreated to represent another model, and you can find a lot of ideas from only this model that can be really quite interesting. For example, think about this. This is nothing else that some Imperial troops from Age of Sigma that has been modified, and the effect is really quite amazing. And you can apply, for example, similar things to create your own zombie. So there are quite a lot to personalize your army. And you can paint in different ways to represent different legions. You can have different scheme of colors. There are a lot of things. Think about also simple bases like this one. Simple, but really quite effective. So there are a lot of options that you can use. Here you can think about having an inspiration about basing, because this is really quite interesting about realizing your basis for your miniatures. Eventually, remember that I have also a playlist about basis for the miniatures. I put in the description also this one. But you can see that there can be quite simple effect that can be really quite amazing. Only one thing, not to do such a thing. If you want to paint these parts, okay, keep off from the sprue and paint them separately, because otherwise if you cut off after, you risk to ruin the color that you put, and you have to clean anyway the model, the part that it's on this. So don't do such a thing. It's an example to make you see that you have to paint them, but don't do on the sprue itself. Then we can find other paintings that can be really quite interesting. It's really nice this way to paint, for example, a corrode weapon, that I think that it's really quite interesting. And a lot of different ways to paint. I think that it's really quite interesting. So I suggest you to give a sight. And here we can find instead an article about Underworld, the Beastgrave, so the different way to play and so on. I think that it's really quite interesting, so I suggest you to give a sight about this, because I don't play such a game, but I like a lot the models. I have some of them, and you can find in the description if you want the ones that I collected. And so there are quite a lot of things that you can have a sight about. So I think that if you're interested about different strategies and so on, can be quite a nice reading about. So give a try. And then we have new rules about Blackstone Fortress. Almost every month in the White Dwarf we can find them. So it's really quite interesting in such a way for the ones that play Blackstone Fortress. Also this part you can scan without any problem, because you have the option. So there are really quite a lot of things that you can use. Then we have about the Aeronautica Imperialis, so new models, new description that you can have referee about. I think that they can be really quite interesting in such a way, really nice. Then we have about Middle Earth with the new costs that you can have about them, and I think that they are really quite nice to represent your own Eteras, if you want, personalize, for example, some Banshees, some Wright, or some other than the one that are for Middle Earth. So there are really quite interesting ones, and I think that they can be used also to create your own models. For example, these ones can be converted a bit to represent, for example, some White King or something else, or even some skeletons eventually. Really quite interesting, a bit of work, and can be really quite an amazing ones. And then we have this that it's related about Black Rabbit, that it was missing for some months in the White Dwarf, and now it come back. Here it's because there has been released the sisters, and they propose you the new romance about James Swallow that has realized other options, other romances. So for example, we can find this, and you can find this in the collection about the Blood Angels, all these ones separately, that are the first omnibus and the second omnibus, because these are quite rare. For example, I have only the second omnibus but not the first. Remember that you have also this, that it's the comprehensive of all the previous omnibus about the Blood Angels. So the first and the second one, they are inside here. If you want, in the future I'll also realize a review about this book, because or better, this book, because there are a lot of ones inside here, so they're really quite interesting ones. And we can see that there are quite a lot of information inside. Moreover, there is a quite interesting thing in this one, and there is a part of a complete fiction. So there is this novel that it's The Fate and Fire, and here we can find the first part about it, so a complete part of the book, the novel about Faith and Fire. So it's really quite interesting to read it, and it's quite complete. So if you're interested about this, I suggest you to read, because there can be a lot of information that you can gain from this, and it's a way to read a book and have the way to have the idea to buy also other books about Black Library that introduce quite a lot of background about such universes that can be either from the Warhammer 40k or from Age of Sigmar or Warhammer Fantasy. Here we can find the Inside Studio, and we can find a lot of ideas also here. For example, we had this modifying to realize some necromancer, that it's a combination of different ways and can be really quite interesting also in this part. So there are things that we see in the future numbers of the White Dwarf, but yet we can find some ideas how to realize and create. And here we can find the alternative cover for this White Dwarf, that it's about the Orcs against the Seraphon. Sincerely, I love this one. I think that it's really quite amazing one, so quite really amazing. I pity a bit that there is not the option to have it directly without the writing song, because it's quite amazing. And here we can find what we'll find in the next White Dwarf, so an anticipation. In this case, I think that it's related about the Space Wolves, but there are also the Orcs, so I don't know if it's mainly related about Space Wolves, or there will be a battle report that it's about these two armies. Anyway, I think that there can be a really quite interesting one. Anyway, what to say about this White Dwarf? I think that it's really quite amazing. A lot of rules, and the fact that you can copy the part, for example, for the Volkai and the Blackstone Fortress, I think that it's really good and a way to make better. So surely later they will sell you such cards and so on, but for now that they are available for you to make a scan and be available, I think that it's quite nice. So I suggest you also for this eventually, if you're interested in such games, to buy it. And I want also to remember you that inside there are fictions, a lot of paintings, a lot of referring about modeling, so about conversions. So I think that it's really quite interesting as a modelism magazine, so really quite nice. So I suggest you to buy this and try, because I think that it's quite worth your money in this case. So
from Deynomod it's everything. I invite you to put a like on this video, to subscribe to the channel, to ring the bell, and to comment this video if you are interested in something about this video, or you want to suggest me some arguments for other videos. I hope to see you again. Till next time.